Hello and welcome. I've been challenged by a YouTuber named Dwendon. I suggest you go watch his videos and listen to his cool commentary. Of course, I will put a link in the video descriptions to his channel. And he challenged me to record a video using a fake French accent. It shouldn't prove too difficult because French is my mother language, but we'll see about that. So here goes. This is the French fake accent challenge. And you may recognize this map. It's one of Vex's early maps. It's called Infernal Sky, the first one. And it is an old map, so it was designed to be played on... it wasn't designed to be played using the release version of Minecraft. So I have reverted back to Minecraft Beta 1.7.3 to record this video and play this map. And actually it is one of my favorite maps. I like the barren islands and stuff like that. But the fact is I have never celebrated my victory on this map by building something out of the ordinary. I had a little shack here, but it was really, really ugly. So I decided to tear it down block by block, put everything in chests, and then decided I would build a treehouse. But I wouldn't settle for one of Minecraft's standard trees. So first of all, I decided to build myself a custom tree. And this is only a progress report. Keep in mind it's a work in progress. And there are lots of stuff to do. But here it is. It is looking, well, big, let's say big. But first of all, let's look around. First, this little meadow in itself was kind of a challenge because on this map there was very few patches of grass. I think there were like four blocks of grass here, and I think there were maybe two in a different location over there in a very awkward position. Hey, no pushing, right? Okay, thank you. And there was also there were also very few blocks of dirt. So I collected everything and disposed all of them here in this fashion. Collected everything I could, like the jack-o'-lanterns and the mushrooms, and also the sugar canes. This little pool was handmade by me too. And I'm running very low on dirt. I have to keep some of it to be able to make some tree farms. I have another one over there. And I am also running very low on glowstone, which is a real pain because each time I place a glowstone block, I have to ponder like for 10 minutes to make sure it's in the right place. Because of course, this is a beta version, so no enchantment, no silk touch pickaxe to get it back. Each time I have to change the block, I have to destroy it, and of course the glowstone dust allows me to make less and less blocks. But let me show you inside. I decided to go for to make a ladder. It would have been cooler with a winding staircase inside the trunk. but using this stair would have been a pain in the butt to get to the top, so I decided for a more straightforward approach. Little balcony here, and my initial idea was to make each branch as a different room. So this one is like a chest storage area, and the next one would be the farm, the wheat farm, and the next one is the kitchen, and you have some furnaces and workbenches. Began to make some bookshelves, and I intend to make a library in some other room. But then again, I began to build the crown of the tree, you know, the canopy all around here. There are small spheres of leaves. And by the way, I forgot to mention it, but everything here was legitimately built, and so it means I have worked a lot on ledges and stuff like this, and I realized that leaves have the same problem as stairs and half slabs and slabs. The fact is, sometimes, even though you are crouching, well, you just fall off. And I fell off, I think it was the other way, but it was about this height, and I was very lucky to be still alive after this fall. I think I had like half a heart left, but now I'm working on the next level, and of course I would fall to my death, which hasn't happened yet. This part is not finished yet. Those little, well, they are not little, they are quite well, it depends if you count the work needed to build them or their size. They may not look very big, but they took a lot of leaves and wood to make, and I intend to make more spheres here and connect all the rooms so that you can go around all the tree, and so that the spheres make like a ring around here, a main ring. And then of course I will have to finish the tree by adding something on top in the middle, and I'm not certain of what. Probably I would make like a bedroom of some kind with a glass roof on top, but I'm not sure yet. This will be required for the tree to have a proper look, so that with the first level of branches, then the outer ring, and then the top ring, you will get this bubble-like appearance that will make it look actually like a tree. Of course, the tree right now has a very geometric look, and it was deliberate of my part. I didn't want to make it look too natural. And so I hope you like it. Mindfin, my friend, if you watch this, I hope you approve of my little house, and I will keep you posted of the when this is actually finished. And this is the end of the French fake accent challenge. I hope you enjoyed it, and I would like you to put in the comments what you think about this accent thing, if you liked it, if you didn't like it, if it's difficult to understand, if it's plain ridiculous, if you want me to stop or keep using it. Put all your love and hate in the comments, and I will take your advice in consideration. So thank you for your time, and see you next time in another video.